Okay, Ragesh.
Thank you, sir.
Now, one second. I want to tell the honorable members, some members are coming and asking whether they will speak tomorrow. No, this discussion will be concluded today. No question tomorrow. Yes, please, sir.
Thank you, sir. Sir, we are discussing this issue of farmer suicide and agrarian distress. At a time when farmers are organizing a lot of agitations, be it in Tamil Nadu, be it in Madhya Pradesh, in Maharashtra and elsewhere. Sir, at the very outset, I am requesting the honorable members sitting there to go through their own election manifesto. Sir, the NDA's election manifesto suggests, clearly states that, I quote, agriculture is the engine of India's economic growth and the largest employer, and BJP commits highest priority to agriculture growth, increase in farmers' income and rural development. Sir, unfortunately, today, the engine which has been depicted here, the engine has been breakdown. That is what happened. Sir, lot of promises are being made in their election manifesto. As already explained here, 50% profit over and above the cost of production, cheaper input and higher technologies for agriculture, farming, and also high yielding seeds, linking MNREG with agriculture, price stabilization funds, and many more. Sir, if at least 20% of these promises are being met, sir, we should have certainly avoided the present devastating situation so far as the agriculture sector is concerned. Sir, yes, you had promised Achadin, good days for farmers. And what is that good day, sir? Sir, the National Crime Records Bureau states 2015-16, there has been 12,602 farmer suicides. And compared to 2014-15, it is an increase of 42%. And sir, in Maharashtra alone, 4,291 farmers were committed suicide. This is the ever highest figure in our history. Is this the good days that you have offered? And when somebody is raising the question of the suicide of farmers, what is your response? You are saying that farmers are committing suicide because of the failure in love affair and due to impotency. That is what you are saying. And we have got a state minister saying that those farmers committed suicide are cowards and criminals. How are you going to address the question of farmer suicide? Don't put the blame on farmers. Unfortunately, you are doing that. It has already been said here in the house itself. It has already been said. You can go through the records. And sir, you have promised 50% profit over and above the cost of production. And what is the situation? I had asked a question in this house whether the government is going to implement the promise that you made in your election manifesto so far as ensuring 50% profit is concerned. What is the answer? It was an emphatic no. Emphatic no. And explain. Yeah. That is what I am saying. And explain that if it is being implemented, the private players will be compelled to run away from the market. Sir, whom are you concerned about? Are you concerned about the suicide, the farmers who are suiciding? Or are you concerned about the private players, the Adanis and Ambanis, Tesco, Walmart and Wilmar, etc.? Are you concerned about that? You must explain that, sir. And, sir, Why it is happening, sir? We all are saying that on the one side, we are talking about the price rise when you are going to market and purchase something. When we know that there is a huge price rise. At the same time, on the other side, farmers are saying we are not getting any prices. Sir, what does it mean? It means that prices are there for the commodities. But at the same time, those prices are not going to the farmers who are producing those products. These prices are being looted by the middleman, the corporates. How? Through your speculative business, futures trading. Your futures trading and speculative trading paves way for price rise in a speculative manner, which ultimately denies the right of the farmers. And also your import policy that leads to the farmers not getting even the remunerative prices. I can tell you the example that has already been explained here. That import duty on wheat, and that also at a time when there is a bumper production of wheat exist. And at that time, you have slashed the import duty on wheat from 25% to 0%. Why, sir? Why did you do that? Why did you allow the foreign players and those who import commodities from foreign countries to import and dump wheat in our country that ultimately led to the farmers not getting even the MSP, minimum support price? What did you make? What arrangement that you make to ensure MSP or procure wheat? Did you make any arrangement to procure wheat at that time when farmers are compelled to sell out wheat at distressed price? No, sir. So whom are you serving for? Are you serving the interest of the farmers or are you serving the corporates? Unfortunately, sir, their policy is serving the corporates only, not the farmers. That is one of the important reasons for the suicide. Sir, and again, you have said that you are going to link MNREG with the agriculture sector, but unfortunately you have slashed budgetary allocation for MNREG. And as per the Act, you have to pay back the wages within a fortnight period, whether the workers are getting the wages on time. No, sir. The central government is yet to transfer 20,000 crores of rupees to the state. So, in the head of MNREG. So they are destroying the very concept of providing jobs to the people, and that also affects the agrarian sector, sir. And Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana, which has already been explained here, sir, the premium, sir, in 2016-17. Three more minutes.
Okay.
2016-17. Total premium that has been collected is 21,500 rupees. And what is the disbursed amount during this same period? It is only 714.14 crores. What does it mean? You have allowed the insurance companies to loot the government, to loot the farmers with a tune of 20,000 crores. And you are saying that we have made such a yojana. Yes, you have got lot many yojana, which is prefixed with Pradhan Mantri. Lot many yojana. 11 or 12 yojanas are there. But irrespective of all these yojanas, why the farmers are committing suicide? That you have to think of. Because you are allowing the corporates to loot the farmers. And, sir, so far as the Kerala is concerned, sir, we have been demanding.
Okay.
The rubber farmers are getting only 100 rupees nowadays. Earlier in 2011, they were getting 243 rupees. Now it is around 100 rupees. Why, sir? Because of the import duties, import policy. These tire manufacturers were allowed to import rubber from international market, Bangkok market, with a cheaper import duty that amount to the devastated situation so far as the rubber farmers are concerned. And we have been demanding for the, what is the result? Farmers are on the verge of suicide. And at the same time, the tire manufacturer, you go through the records, their profit is getting increased day by day. They are making huge profit. And you are allowing the tire manufacturers to loot the farmers. And that is what your policy is. And sir, you are so concerned about the non-performing assets caused by corporates, and you are ready to write off. Yes, our finance minister time and again used to say that it is not waiver, but it is only a book adjustment. Whatever may be the case, you are ready to write off the NPAs made by the corporates. And it is to a tune of lakhs of crores of rupees. And what about the loans taken by the poor farmers who are committing suicide?
Okay.
Why don't you go for a loan waiver so far as the farmers' loans are concerned?
Please.
You are more concerned about corporate loans. You are ready to adjust
write
off corporate loans. And I am requesting through you, sir.
Okay, fine.
I am requesting you. This is very important issue.
Okay.
Sir, this is very important issue.
I
the government
agree.
Is
it's
not
important.
Concerned about that. When farmers are committing suicide, the decry of farmers are falling in the deaf ears, and they are not ready to listen. They are not ready to see the agony of the farmers. And
listen.
I am requesting them to see the agony of the farmers and come with the loan waiver and change your policies. Whatever change policies that you are putting forward for the corporates, change those policies.
Thank you.
And that is the only way to address this question.
Okay, thank you,
sir. See,